Skully is a 3D puzzle platformer from Finish Line Games, where you control a skull partially reanimated with magical clay, and help the Earth Elemental who created you break up a feud between his other three siblings. Skully's story is lighthearted and comical, but tries its hand at drama as well. Your maker, Terry, is sort of a goof.
Look at you, you're... Wait, where's the rest of you?
But desperately wants his other elemental siblings to stop fighting for dominance over the world, as each wants to cover the planet with their specific element, rather than keep a balance of air, water, fire, and earth. The plot is primarily dished out via well-done voice interactions between the characters during levels, interspersed with cutscenes. I wasn't a fan of the grainy and stilted look of these scenes, but they get the narrative across. Skully itself cannot speak. Early on, it can roll swiftly through the landscape, jump between platforms, and stick to specific walls, but over the course of the game, it will gain new abilities by forming clay golems. While at a clay pool, Skully can become a powerful hulking golem, a small and quick golem, or a golem that can double jump. Each form has two or three powers that can be put to use in a variety of situations to help you get around or to create a new path forward. The puzzle design is gratifying, as several can be solved in a number of ways. You can elect to Hail Mary yourself across a gap with the power golem, or move platforms into position with the smaller ones to jump across. Any combination of the three types can be left out in the level for you to switch between, and some can perform autonomous tasks for you. The game is at its best when it's making you use multiple golem types and their abilities, but platforming was a consistent headache. As a tiny rolling object, Skully is fast but can be unwieldy. Momentum never felt consistent, and I'd over or undershoot simple jumps regularly. The often uneven terrain can also be disruptive, as hitting a bump just before trying to jump will negate the input. The biggest cause of death is the unruly camera that hides behind walls or blocks your view with your character. Things are a bit easier when in golem form, but each one retains some level of imprecision in their platforming. Luckily, the clay pools that double as checkpoints are numerous, but that doesn't make repeated deaths in small, tricky sections feel any less unfair. The few enemy types are less of a direct threat and function more like hazards to avoid, which I preferred, and boss encounters follow suit, placing you in a platforming challenge rather than a direct combat scenario. However, these encounters were all very basic, and even with better platforming controls, wouldn't have been any more entertaining. Skully's art style is also underwhelming. The elemental characters exude so much personality in their performances, yet their visual designs are comparatively bland. The levels themselves also felt generic visually and just didn't stand out much. The soundscape and music were mostly pleasant, at least. Skully has some strong puzzle gameplay that's hampered by weaker platforming. The story could be a delightful 8-hour adventure for a younger player, but keep in mind there's a lot you'll be banging your head about. The game is out August 4th for $29.99 on Xbox One, PlayStation 4, Nintendo Switch, and PC.